Matías Kumar. Arimana. María Silvia Esteve from Aspire. Y Jan Soldat from Stitching Back. Quelques mots sur l'idée de, enfin, sur les programmes des courts-métrages que vous allez voir aujourd'hui et demain, et sur les principes en fait, avec lesquels on les sélectionne, on les visionne. On se réfère beaucoup voilà, à une période qui était voilà, la période des années 70 de la quinzaine, je le répète souvent, où les courts-métrages étaient les courts-métrages des films de Stan Brakhage, de Carolee Schneeman, de Paul Charitz, et c'était justement, c'était des artistes qui exploraient vraiment de nouvelles formes de narration à l'époque, et des artistes visuels. Donc pour sortir un peu de cette idée que les courts-métrages, c'est juste un passage voilà, pour arriver au long-métrage. En fait, il y a énormément d'artistes qui travaillent des formes de moins d'une heure pendant toute leur carrière, et qui ont pour moi extrêmement contribué à l'histoire du cinéma et au développement de nouvelles formes de narration. Et c'est le cas, c'est un exemple parfait qu'on peut avoir un ours d'or comme Radu Judé et puis venir présenter un court-métrage à la quinzaine des réalisateurs. Merci beaucoup Radu. Et c'est avec cet esprit, donc vous n'allez pas voir forcément, voilà, vous allez avoir, on l'espère, des expériences audiovisuelles inédites et enrichissantes.
A few words about the selection and the way we select our ethnics when we select the short films. We always think about the Back to the 70s, the director's fortnight films, where it was visual artists like Stan Brakhage and Carolee Schneeman and Paul Charitz who invented new narrative forms. And it's a way also for us to say that short films are not just a transition into a feature film, because we have people who win the grand prize in the Berlinale, and then like Radu Judé, and come here at the Quinzaine to show a short film. And so we hope that you will have visual experiences, audiovisual experiences that you've never experienced before.
Une question pour tous les réalisateurs et les actrices. Un mot pour nous présenter votre film.
Just a word to each of you to introduce each of you to present your film.
Hello, I'm Jamel McInnes, the director of As Time Passes. It's a film of trying to make sense of one's internal life with the external around them. And as much as myself tried to build this film, a lot of it became about stripping back to then find what it is that we really have and the humanity within that process. So through journal entries, words from my mother, words of the people around me, ultimately to get to the truth of what is this all mean. So I hope you guys enjoy.
My name is Kenzen, like Morgan Poquet, and I want to salute everybody from my crew, like Ada Solomon, the producer, Indiana Calavia, production manager, and Cassandra Gitch, who's an actress, and my friend Roger Cosa from Argentina, who's here. I cannot avoid him, I'm sorry. And just to say, taking over from Mr. Moretti, that Brakhage has a wonderful essay that we can find on the internet called In Defense of the Amateur. And in a way, I consider the film an amateur film. I consider myself an amateur filmmaker in certain ways. And one more thing, the film references Le Grand Salopard, Mr. Putin, but it's made last year. So if I would make it today, I would say fuck you, Mr. Putin, in the film. But I couldn't. I made it last summer. Thank you so much.
I want to thank so much Le Quinzaine to invite the film, that I can be here again after 11 years. I really want to say thank you to my crew. Without you, it would not be possible. Thank you, Friederike Hertz, for the script. Thank you, Luciana Riso, the DOP. Thank you, Martin Backhaus, for the all the post-production. It's all in-house. And thank you, Ariane Grot, the composer. And I as well want to say a few words, like it's the first Colombian film which is thinking indigeneity and queerness together, that it's not a contradiction, that it can go hand in hand together. And that being trans is not a white thing, has a very long history in a lot of different cultures in this world. So this film is the legacy and history which is invisibilized structurally and not seen. So thank you.
Hi, I'm Natalia Escobar, co-director with Simone Arribada. I would like to thank also the Cansem for having us here, to the amazing crew, and also to our talent, Las Traviesas, the community of trans indigenous women from the Mbera tribe, for trusting us and for letting us dive into their rich and beautiful universe, their cosmovision, and to be able to like give this little window, like this glimpse of their world through this platform. So I hope you enjoy it.
Hello, my name is Maria Silvia Esteve. I'm the film director of The Spiral. This is a film that is intended to be a journey. Basically I made this film throughout 2 years, editing alone in my computer and animating and doing compositing. And it was basically my way of trying to tell a friend that I could understand her, that I could really reflect on what she was going through, and The Spiral is my way of telling her that I'm sorry and that what she feels and what she feels that is wrong within her is not something that is wrong. It's just that she questions like the origins, and so The Spiral does that. It talks about, in the end, it's a spiral, it descends into the core, and the core in the end is home. And does home really feel like home? Thank you.
Hello, my name is Jan Soldat. I'm the director of Staging Death. Thank you. I'm really surprised that you choose the film. It's really exciting to be here and have fun.
Thank you.